Alright people, we're back with our latest wood carving. What we're going to be doing is a hummingbird. It's my last one I'm doing for this month. It's going to be a birthday present for my mother, so she likes birds and has a little hummingbird feeder and loves watching them buzz around, so I thought it'd be the perfect one. If you can tell, we've just made some general guidelines. I don't know how I'm going to follow those, but let's go ahead and get started. If you've noticed, I've made some dotted lines right here at the neck and down here, and I've done that on both sides because we're going to have to shrink the head down and the tail down, and then we can shape the body, and then we're going to shape the wings. Now, when hummingbirds fly, they have kind of a rotary motion to their wings, so I don't know how I'm going to show that in the carving, but I'm going to give the wings some sort of curvature to at least make them look realistic. Alright, so let's go ahead and just detail the eye real quick. And this is just a plunging cut, that way when I remove this part of the face or head or whatever you want to call it, these marks I'm making deep into the wood will show up, and that way you don't have to try and freehand match up where the eyes were. Because you can tell relatively how far we're going over. Now obviously the head's not going to be that big, but that's just a general guideline. Right, so let's go ahead and at an angle, we're slicing in a circular type motion. Split it here. It's gonna be tough. Now, in a case like a bird like this has such a small beak, if you're having to remove parts of the face to get it down to the exact size you want to start actually shaping, try not to break the beak, anything long like this, because if you happen to break the actual one, you might be able to go back and salvage this piece to fix your actually finished carving. I don't know about you guys, but where I'm at, the allergies are just horrible. Can't hardly breathe today. And this is another somewhat of a plunging cut. Coming in at an angle. But as I push down, I'm rocking the knife forward so that the blade's actually doing the cutting. So it should come free now. There we go. I'm going to sit that off to the side there. Do this with the other side as well. find something different music-wise. I can't do this crap in the background. I didn't choose the music. It's on a music app and just shuffles through all kinds of different ones, so that's gonna have to go here in a minute. Now you can see the general concept we're doing here. We're going to finish working the head down to the general shape we want it. We're going to do the same thing with the tail, and then we'll be back with the next step after that.